Hi, it's Wesley, and welcome to day 3 of International Zine Month 2021. Today's prompt is, look up virtual zine events to attend. When else are you going to be able to attend a zine event in a different city or even country for free? So, I have a quick and dirty list of a few online zine events that are coming up in the next few months, and I'm just going to do a pretty rapid fire. All of these are based in the US just because they're the events that I'm familiar with, but you should definitely look up to see if there are any local to you that may be moving online this year anyway. Portland Zine Symposium, July 24th through 25th, is online this year, and we're going to be sharing zines with the hashtag VirtualPZS2021. There will be workshops and events, and one event that sadly I can't go to because I have work, but it looks really cool, which is trauma-informed reflective writing through zines. So you should definitely check that out. Make sure that you register for events ahead of time. They're all free, but you do need to register on Eventbrite through their website, so I'll link there. Again, Portland Zine Symposium, July 24th through 25th. Queer Zest Zine Fest, from August 7th through 8th. That's going to be online this year. There are some fabulous tablers, including myself. There will be workshops, and there is a community Discord that you can join and talk to fellow zine enthusiasts or other zinesters or tablers, and they're really focused on building up an online community, so that's going to be great. Again, Queer Zest Zine Fest, August 7th through 8th. Street Cat Zine Fest, August 21st. This is actually going to be a mostly in-person event centered in Ohio, but they do have mail-in options, and they have a mail-in zine trade event that's happening, so you should definitely keep an eye out and check that out. Again, that's Street Cat Zine Fest, August 21st. Bay Area Queer Zine Fest, from September 6th through 12th. There will be workshops and a bunch of really cool tablers. I applied, so I might be tabling. If you are interested in tabling yourself, applications are still open, and for people who fall under the LGBTQIA umbrella, and the applications are open until July 15th. So if you're interested in tabling, you should totally apply. Again, Bay Area Queer Zine Fest, September 6th through 12th. Pikes Peak Zine Fest goes from October 1st through 2nd, and that will have exhibitors, workshops. They do a zine anthology that you can submit to. They have a mail-in zine swap, and they will also have some in-person events if you happen to be close enough to Colorado Springs to go to that. So I am really excited. I'm probably going to check out the anthology some more, see if I can submit to that. Sounds really fun. So Pikes Peak Zine Fest, October 1st through 2nd. And the last one on my list is the Twin Cities Zine Fest, which goes from October 15th through 17th. And that will have exhibitors and workshops, and they also do zine readings, and they do zine videos. They have a YouTube, so that'll be really cool, and you'll get to hear some zinesters read off their own zines. That's always really fun. Twin Cities Zine Fest, October 15th through 17th. That's my quick list of events that I just wanted to highlight and show off, and of course a couple that I will be attending. There are more places that are starting to do in-person events, or hoping to do in-person events in the fall or early next spring, so while things are starting to open back up again, a lot of them are doing these hybrid online or in-person things, so definitely check out all of these zine fests that I've mentioned, and if there are any in your area, you should definitely look those up. If you have a specific area and you're not sure where to start, then I can try and help you find some zine fests in your area or in your country. Yeah, so definitely a good year to check out a zine festival and some of these online workshops, especially if you've never been. It's never been more accessible, so you should definitely check it out. I also have a resource that I really like that I'm going to be sharing for people who are interested in tabling at a zine fest or otherwise sharing their art. This is a Tumblr blog called How to Be a Con Artist, which is about artists tabling, and it has a ton of advice on just stuff you should bring, how much you should bring. It has advice for finding printers, printer recommendations, printing stickers or making enamel pins or acrylic charms, and like, it's been going on for years and years, so it has just a huge backlog of resources and recommendations, and of course a lot of them are very applicable to zine creators and zine tablers. So that's going to be linked in the description. That is How to Be a Con Artist, really great resource. And the free zine that I have to show off today is titled Pop-Up Girls, and that is by Himali Patil and Tasha De Silva. Sorry if I mispronounce anything. And it is a really nice illustrated zine about these girls' experience in going to a few different places and setting up a clothing pop-up shop. It's primarily places in India, and the illustrations are really cute, really colorful, really engaging, and I felt like it was sort of thematically appropriate, you know, for zine fests. I think that the concept of tabling is sort of similar to the concept of pop-up shops, and that's about the closest one that I could find that was thematically relevant, which is weird that I actually haven't seen all that many zines about zine fests. I guess because the people are just there at the zine fest? I don't know. It's kind of interesting, but this is a really good zine anyway, and I'm glad that I had to branch out my search a little bit and happen upon it. It is, again, Pop-Up Girls, and I will have a link to the free PDF for you to read it in the description below. Thanks so much for watching, and I hope that you are interested in checking out some of these online zine fests or a zine fest near you. And I will see you again tomorrow for the prompt for day 4. Bye!